Welcome to the fourth episode of The Hello Show. This episode will wrap up the second week of this series, so let's get into it right now. There's a lot of reality TV shows on TV. A lot. And a lot of them are said to be fake, and some are real. But which ones are fake? We're going to go over that today. And I'm going to read to you why they're fake. So starting off, we're going to start with The Voice. The Voice is an American singing competition based on The Voice of Holland. Its goal is to find new singing talent aged 15 years old and above from the blind audition before the start of each season. The blind audition is characterized by judges facing backward, only hearing the voice of one auditioning. The winner of the show is determined by votes from the audience and purchases of the contestant's song on iTunes. Though the voice shows no sign of being scripted, the fact remains it's an intense competition for a singing contract, which is an unrealistic event for most people. So basically, the show's fake. And I mean, maybe it's not, but according to this, it is. So, let's go to the next one. The X Factor. And 1 second. Sorry about that. A notification came up on the camera and we had to dismiss it. The X Factor. Created by Simon Cowell, The X Factor is a television music competition franchise that originated in the United Kingdom. It was only originally created to replace Pop Idol and is now held in several countries around the world. The mechanics of the show involves drawing aspiring pop singers to the competitive auditions and selecting the one with the X Factor, which refers to that special characteristic that makes won a promising star. Some critics believe that the auditions conducted by the show are senseless because contestants are already pre-selected. So, contestants are already pre-selected, so people that are, good or bad, like people that would embarrass themselves to make this show popular, and make people want to watch it, those people are, like, pre-selected. So really, it's not really reality. It's kind of like, okay, you're going to be on the show, basically. The next one. Hell's Kitchen. Hell's Kitchen, actually, none of these shows that I watch, except the last one, which we'll get to. Okay, we'll get to that one. Hell's Kitchen is an American reality cooking show competition. Basically, this says that people in the restaurant, like customers and whatnot, are paid actors, and that the show is scripted, and it's just, let's see here, it has been speculated that the show is indeed scripted. During the second season of Hell's Kitchen, it was speculated that the customers eating meals prepared by contestants were in fact paid actors. One of the most controversial accusations of staging relates to the contestant Joseph Tinley, who during one elimination round challenged Ramsey Fyfe. I don't know if that makes sense. I don't know if that was typed correctly. Maybe there's a typo. I don't know. The incident was labeled as an overplayed and possibly faked scene conducted to cause action and tension on the show in order to spark viewer interest. Now, a lot of these shows, I'm pretty sure, are fake. Like, I know Jersey Shore, Keeping Up with the Kardashians, all these popular reality TV shows, even Hardcore Pond, which I was actually watching this morning, some of it's probably real, some of it's fake. That's where the reality comes in. There's some reality, but most of it's fake. And last but not least, Ghost Hunters. I love Ghost Hunters. I watch it all the time, and I'm a big fan of it. And I think there's some reality in there, but I think you gotta put some fake into it, so people would watch it. You don't want to have people ghost hunting and not get anything, and oh, it's boring. So you gotta put some fakeness into it for people to enjoy it. So an American paranormal reality television series, Ghost Hunters, first aired on October 6th, 2004, and features several paranormal investigators, including Jason Hawes and Grant Wilson. In the series, these paranormal investigators explore places that are reportedly haunted. In 2008, it was criticized by several critics when, in one of its episodes, the collar of the lead investigator, Grant Wilson, was claimed to have been pulled down by an unforeseen force three times. Because one of his hands was strangely positioned at his side during the video, critics were led to believe that it was only him who was pulling a string to make his collar move. I will try to find the footage of this and put it in the episode. And, yeah. My neck really hurts. I slept on it wrong. So those reality shows are fake. But there's probably some reality in them. You know, there's reality and fakeness. You gotta keep TV entertaining. So, yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna do a weird food challenge today. And I'll probably do a weird food challenge a lot on this show. And a weird drink challenge. And this one came from a website. I can't remember the name of the website. I was on it. I just came across it. And it was a random food generator. And so I did three items. I don't even have a spoon. I should go get one. I'll be right back. I got a spoon. So on the random food generator, I got dog food, square cheese, and mustard. I did mustard on Tuesday with the oatmeal cream pie. I got it again. So I'm gonna make it into like a little wrap. Oh, this is just great. Right there's the dog food, the mustard, and the cheese. So I'm gonna put everything on the cheese and make it into a little wrap. So let's try this. Okay, I'm actually gonna... I don't know the name of the website. I forgot. I came across it and lost it. This is going to be great. Please subscribe. This is disgusting. Got another notification on the screen here on the camera. Sorry about that. There's a lot of technical difficulties today. Camera just likes to act up sometimes. So let's try this. It's probably gonna be gross. I'm sorry if I don't seem so into the show today. I'm just kind of tired. And I had a migraine last night. And I still kind of have it. This is probably just gonna make it worse. Here it goes. It's not that bad. Really not that bad. It's not good. But it's not bad. Thank you for watching this episode. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And also go to subscribe to Super Sid and H. It's my friend's YouTube channel. So go subscribe to her. And the link to her channel will be in the description below. And I will catch you guys on Tuesday.